As world leaders continue to address the United Nations General Assembly, another event in New York, attended by high-level officials, focused on the critical role women play in peace building around the globe and how to protect them from the threats they often face when doing so.
Rape and sexual violence in conflict continue with impunity. Women peace builders face reprisals for speaking out on atrocities. The real world examples are all around us. In Afghanistan, where women are forced into the shadows and subjected to what many call rightly gender apartheid. In Sudan, the cries of women and girls seem sometimes to have been forgotten despite ongoing suffering and atrocities.
The importance of women being able to hold leadership positions and have equal and meaningful participation in decision-making processes was underscored by Romania's foreign minister, Luminița Odobescu.
And in order for this process to be irreversible, education for gender equality and inclusion is key. Education of children and youth, paramount for a sustainable future, but also education of adults and professionals in different sectors, including those in security institutions.
U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken announced new initiatives to bolster the global fight for women's and girls' inclusion.
One new way we'll do this is by supporting the WPS Centers of Excellence that are building connections between government officials and civil society leaders and helping them integrate gender perspectives into peace and security policies.
The U.S. government will also release in the fall an updated National Action Plan on Women, Peace and Security, Blinken added.
It outlines how we'll incorporate the needs and the perspectives of women and girls into our own diplomacy, defense, development policies going forward in the years ahead.
In less than a month, the annual report on Women, Peace and Security will be presented to the United Nations Security Council. It will also highlight the need to broaden women's participation in peace-building efforts and lay out proposals to do so. Verónica Valderas Iglesias, VOA News, the United Nations.